Assalamu alaikum, everyone. This is your brother Ali Weather from Japan. So today I have a special guest from Singapore, new converted Muslim, Mr. Ilyas-san. Guys, if you see the below, you will find his channel. So please have to subscribe and support him as well, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hi everyone, hi brothers and sisters. In today's video, it is me and Brother Ali Weda, and I believe that you're watching this on Brother Ali's channel. So if you guys do not know who I am, my name is Ilyas Tan, and I also do my own YouTube videos. And today we are doing a collaboration together to find out more about how our journey to Islam is like and living in different countries. So very excited to be on his channel, and so very excited to share some of the things about my journey as well.
Can I ask you, what's the religion before you convert to Islam?
Oh, before I became a Muslim, I was actually a Buddhist. So okay. I was not really a practicing Buddhist, just here and there. You know, like my parents last time were Buddhist. So I just follow them in whatever they do. So I didn't really go and figure out myself also. I didn't ask much questions. I just thought that, for Chinese people, then most Chinese are Buddhist.
Okay. So do you have any specific incident or like an event that made you the convert to Islam?
Me, myself, I don't really have any major event. I think everything in my life just fell into place. Because when I was younger, not too young, maybe 6 years ago, okay. Mm-hmm. I think my life goal at that time was to chase after success and chase after money. There's a lot of the mindset of people, like younger people. So at that time, I was chasing after mindset, chasing after success and chasing after money at that point of time. And then what happened was I started my own small little business. I made some money and I bought my own car, because car in Singapore is very expensive. Yes. So it's like a dream for everyone to own a car. So example, like a Toyota, like a car Singapore is $100,000. $100,000. So it's very expensive in Singapore. So it is like a dream for a lot of young people as well in my country.
It is like a status. If you have a car, you are success like this.
Yeah, correct, correct. It is like a status. At least that was my mindset back then. Like, and a lot of young people around me, you know, this is what we think. We think that, if you can buy a car, right, you're successful. You know, this is the symbol of success. That is what a lot of people believe in. And that was what I believed in last time. So when I managed to buy my own car at that time, I was happy. I was happy, but for a while only. You know, like afterwards, I was asking myself, like, what is next? You know, like, this is never going to end, right? If I buy, I'll chase after this item, after this car. Then what's next? I will chase after something else. Then after I get that thing, I will chase after the other thing again. So it will be non-stop, you know, like one after the other. And that was when also I started to question about the purpose of life and the meaning of life. So I started to not really find out about religion, because that time I didn't really believe in religion. But I just look into philosophy, you know, that kind of things. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, why do we exist in this earth? You know, I think because I believe that there is more than just making money and becoming successful. So because I see so many people, right? Like you see online, like there are like people who love to do charity, you know, they love to help people, you know, but for me, I cannot understand why people love to do that. You know, like I think they have a different mindset that I cannot understand. So I want to, you know, just explore things as we go along. So And then slowly by slowly, I learned about, slowly by slowly, I finished my army at that point of time.
You have army in your country?
Yeah, yeah. It's compulsory, mandatory. Yeah, like Korean, I think same.
Oh, like same Korea. You must go there at like 1 year. You sleep there. You make a discipline there.
2 years, 2 years.
Oh, 2 years. It's a long time. Like Korea.
Yeah, correct, correct. So at the point of time in army, that was also when I started to think about life, you know, like, because after army, right, for most of the guys, it's after army, you either start working or you start to go to university.
Yeah.
So there's this decision to make. So I was also thinking, what should I do after army? And then that was where I started to think about my life, like where are we here for, and so many other things. And then slowly by slowly, I didn't, you know, things just go on. And then I just started working. I decided to start working, and then I joined a company, and that was a gaming company. We play like games. We help people to play games, that sort of thing. And then that was when I met my girlfriend through a video game.
Really?
Through
video game.
Yeah, it's a rule. It's called Rules of Survival at that time. It's like PUBG mobile. It's like PUBG. Yeah, and then I met her lah. So I knew that she was a Muslim at that point of time.
Mm.
I didn't really care much about religion lah, because to me last time, religion is something that is just there, you know, like whether or not I believe in it, it will not affect the relationship. Or it will not affect the, you know, how I live my life. But I was wrong. But so at that time, I didn't really care about it. And up until, you know, after a few months later, you know, and she told me that if I want to be serious with her and I want to be... after a few months, she told me that if things were to get serious, anyways, so after a few months, she told me that if things were to get, if I'm serious with her, then I will have to become a Muslim. So actually, I was a bit hesitating whether or not I should become a Muslim at that time, because I always thought that Islam or Muslim, it is a religion for the Malay people, because in my country, most of the Muslims are Malay.
Oh.
Yeah, and my neighboring country, which is Malaysia, which is where the Malays, majority of the Malays are, they are all Muslim. So we have a lot of people in my country have this mindset that Muslims are Malays. You know, like how some people think that Chinese is for Buddhism. A lot of people think that Muslims are for Malay. So that was what I thought at the time. So I was hesitating, but I decided to start and learn a bit. To understand what is Islam about before I make my decision. And slowly, as I started to watch more videos and learn about Islam, I started to watch a lot of online lectures
by
Dr. Zakir Naik.
You know him? Yeah, of course.
Yeah. So a lot of people, I think, watch him as well. I think he's very popular.
He came to Japan for 5 or 6 years ago.
Oh. Wow. Did you go and see him?
No, I didn't go there that time. But many people converted to Islam by his leading.
Wow. Okay. Nice. I also heard that this Japanese Muslim is growing, yeah? It's very a lot of Muslim now. More and more.
Yes, but not really. We have Muslim like 0.3% page compared to the whole population. So we have like 20, you know, very, if compared to the 10 years ago, it become like two times. But still very, you know, less than 1%, less than 0.5%. So still very.
I hope that the future will continue to grow in the future. Hope.
Yeah, yeah, I'm very sure. Yeah.
Just now I was saying Dr. Zakir's Naik lecture, right?
Yes, after
I watched more and more of his videos and lectures, I started to understand and learn more about Islam and the misconceptions about Islam.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that it is a religion for everyone, not just for the Malays as well. And also how it compares with other religion, because Dr. Zakir Naik do a lot of video on comparative religion, on how he compares Islam with Christianity, Buddhism, and find the similarities inside of it.
Mm-hmm.
So that was when I started to slowly start to believe in the teachings of Islam.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that the thing, right, that made me believe in Islam the most is the the different signs in the Quran, right? Like when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you know, the universe is expanding, you know, all these different signs in the Quran.
Mm-hmm.
That no one could have known about, you know, 1,400 years ago, right?
Yeah.
Because only in the recent few years that, you know, as science advances, as science gets better and our technology gets better, then we get to understand more about the universe and our Earth and mm-hmm. where we live. And then that is where, you know, slowly and slowly, you know, more of the Quran gets proven to be right and proven to be the truth. And yes, so yes. I think that's the main thing that made me believe in Islam is the mm-hmm. Quran and the word of God, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And all these things just made sense to me. So and because of that, right? Because last time I was always looking for something, right? I was like, that's not the time I tell you in my army, after I had a small success in my small business,
mm-hmm.
I started to you know, look for something out there, like, you know, what is next, you know, what mm-hmm. why are we here for? And then when I learned more about Islam, I realized that this is the truth,
mm-hmm.
and that's why I believe in Islam. And subsequently I became a Muslim
mm-hmm.
last year March. Yeah.
Oh, last year March.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Correct. Yeah. So about 1 year, like, close to 1 year.
Okay. Allah, don't find me. Allah,